Good morning, my dear students. Today's video is of closure property. Some days before, I have uploaded a video related to closure property, but this is another way to understand the property, that is closure or any other property. First of all, before starting this property, we must know about some numbers. First number is the whole numbers. Whole numbers are those numbers which include 0 as well as 2 the n. 0, 2, n. Whole numbers includes 0 as well in it, and the denotation symbol for whole number is W. Okay. Then next is integers. Integers are those numbers which include 0 as well as negative numbers as well. It means the set of numbers having positive numbers, negative numbers as well as 0, whole set is called integers. And how do we denote integers? By Z. Yes, our next numbers are rational numbers. Rational numbers are those numbers which can be denoted in A by B form, which can be denoted like A by B. It means the fractions which are positive as well as negative, the whole of this thing called rational numbers. Means rational numbers are a set of those fractions having positive as well as negative. And how do we denote rational number? By Q. Okay, next. So finally, what did we understand? What is a real number? Real number are those numbers which include whole numbers, integers, rational numbers as well as the natural numbers. All these numbers are included in real number. Okay, so keep this in your mind. What are the real numbers? Real numbers are completely whole numbers which are having natural numbers, which also have whole numbers, integers as well as the rational numbers, the whole of this set called real number. Okay, so now let's start with examples. These examples will help you a lot. It is related to your real life. So first example is, if we are going to add 2 glasses of milk, what did we get? Yes, we will get the milk itself. And if we add 2 glasses of water, what would we get? We get the water. This is the real meaning of our closure property. It means whenever there is a operation, we applied any between 2 real numbers and we get again the real number, it means the closure property hold. And if there is another thing we are getting, there will be no closure property. Again, I am explaining. If we are applying any operation, plus, minus, multiply, division, any operation between 2 real numbers, and we are getting real number in result, it means closure property hold under given operation. And if we are not getting again the real number, then we can say the closure property will not hold. Okay, now move further. Now I am going to take some examples, numerical examples, that is I have added 4 plus 5. I got 9. So, focus. 4 is a whole number. 5 is a whole number. And after adding them, we are getting whole number. After adding 2 glasses of milk, we are getting milk itself. Yes? Move further. 4, whole number, multiplied by 5, again whole number. And I am getting 20. It means it is also a whole number. Whole number is multiplied with whole number and we get whole number again. It means whole numbers are closed under addition as well as multiplication. This is a right way to write the statement about properties. We are checking whole numbers and that's why we have written whole numbers are closed under addition as well as multiplication. Okay, let's move further. Now I have taken minus 6 plus 7. What I am getting? 1. Now focus, minus 6 is an integer, 7 is also an integer, and what I am getting after addition? Integer itself. And when I multiply it, minus 6 multiply 7, I'll get minus 42, which is integers. Again, if I subtract all those two digits, minus 6 minus 7, I got minus 13. Again, integer minus integer, I am getting integer. Milk plus milk, I am getting milk. Milk operation milk, I am getting milk. Milk operation milk, I am getting milk. The same has been done with the milk as well as closure property. And these are all integers. So what did we understand? Integers are closed under addition, multiplication and subtraction, because we have taken all the examples, that is integers 6 and 7, and answer we are getting also integer. It means addition, multiplication, subtraction, closure property hold. Let's move. I have taken minus 2 by 3 plus 4 by 3. And what I am getting? After adding them, I am getting 2 by 3. It means rational number plus rational number, I am getting rational number. If I multiply them, minus 2 by 3 multiply by 4 by 3, I am getting minus 8 by 9. It means rational number multiply by rational number, I am getting rational number again. If I minus them, I am getting rational number again. It means rational numbers are closed under addition, multiplication and subtraction. Let's move. Now where we come now? What is the meaning where closure property doesn't hold? Earlier I have given some examples where the closure property hold. But now we want to know about where the closure property doesn't hold. Think. Move further. If I take 0 minus 7, I'll get minus 7. Yes, I have subtracted two numbers, 0 and 7. And now I got answer minus 7. So focus, 0 is a whole number. 7 is also a whole number, but minus 7 is an integer. See, after giving operation to whole numbers, to the milk, 2 glasses of milk, we are getting another thing. We are not getting the milk again. We are getting another thing. It means here the closure property is not hold. Let's see, 8 divided by 0, if we divide 8 as a whole number, 0 as a whole number, but answer what we are getting is a not defined answer. Yes, so what did we understand? What did we understand about whole numbers? Whole numbers are not closed under subtraction and division, because while we are subtracting two whole numbers, we are not getting whole numbers again. We are getting integer. And while we are dividing two whole numbers, 0 and 8, we are not getting the integer again, whole number again. We are getting not defined answer. It means whole numbers are not closed under subtraction as well as division. Next. Now let us check another example. 5 divided by 6. 5 is an integer. 6 is an integer. Yes, but I am getting 5 by 6, which is a rational number. Again, we are not getting the integer while dividing two integers. Yes. If I divide 5 by 6, which is a rational number, by 0, which is also a rational number, but I got no defined answer. It means, what did we understand? Integers and rational numbers are not closed under division. Because when we divided two integers, we are getting a by b form, which is a rational number. And when we are dividing two rational number, we are getting not defined answer. It means integers and rational numbers are not closed under division. This is what I was telling about. Thank you so much for this video. Hope you understood well.